help Anita continue improving her presentations. Our third speaker tonight is Nicole Dunn. This is project number two from Competent Communicator for Nicole. She has been teaching group fitness for 19 years, and fitness is really a way of life for her. Tonight, she's going to show us how to overcome the biggest obstacle to why people don't work out. Watch her overcome these objections with a visual presentation showing us how to be fit in 15 minutes.
People feel like they don't have enough time. Other reasons include people not having enough money to spend on expensive gym memberships or equipment, or not knowing how to work out properly. Tonight, I'm going to show you a workout you can do in as little as 5 minutes. I'm presenting Fit in 5. The type of workout I'm going to do is high-intensity interval training. How this works, you're going to work out for 45 seconds, high intensity, then take 15 seconds to recover. We're going to do 5 different exercises. You guys ready to get started?
Yeah.
Okay, before we begin,
are you really doing it?
You're welcome to stand if you like, or you can just observe. Before we begin, a few things we need is a clear space, a little bit of room. You need some comfortable clothing. Leg warmers are optional, but definitely preferred. And you'll also need a timer and music. You guys ready?
Yeah.
All right. So first of all, we're going to start off high-intensity interval training. So we're going to do squat. So we're going to start with our feet about hip-width apart or just slightly wider. So this workout is great because we're working big muscle groups. So we're going to start by sitting back on our heels like we're sitting back in a chair. Okay, this workout, this exercise burns a lot of calories, but just this exercise alone. From a side view, you're going to sit back like you're sitting in a chair. You can keep your arms out in front if that's more comfortable, here or next to you. Okay, so we're going to do the squat for 45 seconds on and then recover for 15 seconds. Okay, so that's round one. So remember, we're working out for a total of 5 minutes. So that's our first round. First exercise is squat. The second exercise we're gonna do is push-up. You guys remember doing those in gym class? So let me demonstrate the push-up. This is gonna be working our chest, our upper body, as well as our abs. So I'm gonna come on down to the floor. You're gonna start with your hands wide. I'm gonna do the first set on my knees. Hands are wide, you're coming down, lowering your chest, and then pushing out and away. Keeping your abs and core tight the entire time. Okay, so we've got 45 seconds on for the push-up and then 15 seconds to recover. If you can't get to the 45 seconds, you can start off with 15 seconds and then build up to the 45. Next exercise is a jumping jack. Everyone remembers jumping jacks, yes? So, jumping jacks. This is a great way to get our heart rate up. So we're gonna do a jumping jack for 45 seconds on and then 15 seconds recover. If you're not comfortable doing jumping jacks or doing high intensity exercises, you can do side tap using your arms. Okay, the lower you go, the harder you're working. The key here is to keep your arms going and to get your heart rate up. Okay, so we have squats, push-ups, jumping jack. Next is my favorite, a lunge. So you're gonna step out, keeping the knees 90 degrees, step back and push away. Step out, lunge, step back and then push away. This one may be a little bit more difficult if you're not used to doing a lunge. I'm going to show you from the side view. Step out and then push back. You want to keep the knees here at about 90 degree angles. Okay, a couple more here. So you're going to alternate one leg and then switch to the next. This exercise is important because we're working a lot of muscle groups here. We're working our quads, our hamstrings, and our glutes. It will also get your heart rate up if you do it quickly. Okay, so 45 seconds work. 15 seconds recovery. Okay, so we're on our fourth, that is our fourth exercise. So our fifth exercise is gonna be a plank. Anyone familiar with planks?
Yeah.
So I'm gonna start this one on my knees. You're gonna come on down to the floor, similar to how we did in the push-ups. Come on down to the floor. We're gonna start up here on our elbows, and we're just locking in our core and holding this position. Again, 45 seconds on, and then 15 seconds recovery. This may be one that you can't do for 45 seconds, so I would encourage you start with 15 and go to 30 and then try for the 45 seconds. Okay, so just to review what we've just done, we've done Fit in 5. So five different exercises. Remember what's first? We have squats.
Squats.
And then we have
push-ups.
So you're coming down to the floor, pushing away. Next we have jumping jacks. And then we have lunges. And then last we have plank. Down to the floor and holding. So that's fit in five. I know what some of you are thinking. What if you have more than 5 minutes to work out? So you can take the same workout and repeat it. Okay, so that was 5 minutes. You could do the whole thing again. Then you have fit in 10. And then you have fit in 15 and so on. So you can take this workout and repeat it as many times as you want. So I know another thing you are thinking, what if that was too easy? Did that seem easy maybe for some of you? Some of you that have been working out?
Sure, right.
So I'm going to repeat. I'm going to repeat that whole workout, and I'm going to show you the modification that you can do that's a little bit higher intensity. Ready? Let's see it again. So we had our squat. This time we're going to do a squat jump. You're going to sit back and then jump. Okay? For this one, it's important, land soft. When you land, you want to bend your knees to absorb the impact. Okay, so that would be our higher intensity option, would be a squat jump. For the push-up, instead of going on our knees, you're going to come down and then on your toes. And if you want more of a challenge, there's our push-up option. Jumping jacks, you can do air jacks. Or you can modify by doing two jumping jacks and then one air jack. Again, 40, working up to 45 seconds on, 15 recover. Okay, next we have our lunges. If you remember these, you can switch these to propulsive lunge. Okay, again, landing soft, bending your knees. And then last we have plank. So instead of on your knees, you're going to come down on your toes and hold this position right here. 45 seconds. So there you have it, fit in five. You can take this workout and modify as you see fit. You'll have an increase in strength and flexibility, muscular strength and endurance, burn lots of calories, and have fun while you do it. So now my challenge to you is to try the fit in five workout in the next 24 hours.